Everybody else, just say hi. I don't want to get started until we have a few more people hop on. So,
Jean Inc., Ollie Bloom, and five other people.
Oh, awesome. Okay, Jeannie. Good to see you on here. So, I have a little bit of help from the cutest cameraman on the planet, who I'm married to, Mr. Thistlewood, Denny. And so, I am super excited. I thought it'd be so fun to just show you guys one of my very favorite bows. So if you're just joining us, tell me where you're from and tell me, are you excited about Thanksgiving? Like what you're making for Thanksgiving? I need
Katrina's
all the
from
help.
Washington. Katrina's in Washington State.
Hi, Katrina from Washington State. Welcome. Are y'all making any fun things for Thanksgiving? I need all of the help because it's a little different Thanksgiving this year. We are going to be here and I'm responsible. Normally my mom is cooking Thanksgiving dinner, but this year I'm cooking the Thanksgiving dinner. So... So I need all of the help and the ideas. I'm about to practice making an apple pie today to see if I can actually really make all this stuff. So
I'm ready to test it.
Oh, you're ready to test it. Oh, I've got an apple pie tester here. Okay, so anybody else joining us?
Oh, a bunch of people.
Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. Where are they from? Tell me who's joining us.
Let's see. Carol from New Zealand.
I love her. She is so crafty and fun and amazing. So welcome, Carol. I'm so glad you're on here. This is awesome. We are going to make a super fun bow today. Okay. So this is my version of one of my favorite bows. And I kind of came up with this. Actually, it was a fortuitous mistake. So let me know if anyone's asking questions or if we have
people. Samantha from Kentucky.
Hi, Samantha.
Evan Cooper from Alabama.
Bow making Evan. Evan's like the most brilliant bow maker on the entire planet. So
Teresa from Marietta.
Hi, Teresa.
Cheryl from Magnolia, California.
Hi, Cheryl. Okay, so all you need for this bow is super simple, super easy. You just need this. Now, y'all, I don't know about y'all, but I am all about Buffalo Check this year. And so this fun ribbon is absolutely amazing. It comes from Hobby Lobby and it was $7.99, which of course 50% off. So and I love it. It's 1.5 inches in width, and it's got this a little bit of wire in it, so it has some construction, which makes it easier to make a bow. And then I also have this super small, this is like a mini Buffalo Check ribbon that we're going to be using for the center. So all I do to make this bow, super, super simple, I take it and I make it about 6 inches, is because this is going to be a smaller bow. I'm actually going to hang this bow on stockings, so I'll show y'all. Can you turn the camera? I want to show them the cutest thing that
Cindy from Mississippi and Edie from New Jersey.
Hi, Cindy. I don't know if y'all can see that, but y'all, I found that at a yard sale, and that is what I am using to hang my ribbons in. So it's an old seed packet, like a vintage seed packet, and I found it, and I just wrap the ribbons around, and I have all my tags at the bottom. So if I just pulled this off of there, it's super easy and fun. So, and I'm about to go do a little more yard sailing after this. So, all right. So you want to start with basically just about 6 inches. You're going to take it. And then all I do is I go ahead and just, I make about 12 of these. So that's 3 and 5. And then I'm folding it like this as shown. And really, you're just folding it back and forth. I don't know if y'all can see that. See, this is what it's looking like. And I'm making it just a tiny bit smaller than the other. Each time I fold it, I'm making it just a tiny, like teeny bit smaller than the other side. And just keep doing that. And it's so easy because it's got a little bit of wire to it, so it folds in place. Because this is going to be the basis for our bow. So I just keep going until I have all of the folds that I need, just like this. Can you zoom in a little bit so people can, I just wanna make sure everybody can see this. And then like this, we're just gonna keep going. And let's see how many we have now. Let's count our folds. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 8. I'm going to do 10 on this one. So 9 and then 10. Okay. And then I go ahead and whenever I trim it, I don't know, some people, everybody's different. Some people like the slant on the bow. I kind of like it where it's got that little cute edge to it. So I just fold it in half and then just cut it like that. So you guys can see kind of the end. And then I flip it over and I'm going to do the exact same thing for this side of the bow too. I'm going to cut it just like this. Okay. So there you go. Okay. So here, this is going to be the base for our bow. So all I did, you can see it right there. I've taken it and I just fold it. We've got 10 folds and each one is a little bit graduated. Super, super, super simple. Then you're going to take your smaller ribbon like this. And we're going to trim pieces about this big. Okay. So we're going to make 1, 2. I usually do maybe 7 or 8, 3, as many as you want. 4. And this is probably about 4 inches. 5, 6, 7. Okay, here's how easy. Are y'all ready? And then you just take these. Now, I used to try to do a bunch at a time, but you can only really do effectively about 3 at a time. So you take them, and then all we're going to do is just tie them in the center like this. And we're just doing one knot. We don't double knot it. I'm just going to tie it in the very center like this. And then you pull it as tight as you can. Use your muscles. Okay, and then so it's going to start looking like this. So you kind of see this center here. And then I'm going to take a couple more pieces. And I so these are tied diagonally this way. I flip these and I tie them diagonally the other way. And again, you just do one, just one little tug like this. And then you have all this cuteness right here in the very center. And then let me go ahead and add another one right here. You're just tying them in the center of the bow. That's it. No wire, no nothing, because your ribbon is wired, so it already has a little bit of shape. And then when you're done, and you kind of fluff these out before you fluff the rest of the bow, you're going to fluff these to where you can kind of even trim them a little bit if you have too many. Like this is just, these are just a tiny bit too long, so you just trim the edges of them like this. And you're going to kind of fluff. So it's, this is the center like this. So now it looks like this. I don't know if y'all can see that. Okay, then.
Show that one more time, babe.
Of course, yes. So here, this is what it looks like before we fluff it. It's going to look like this. Okay?
Okay.
And then, here's the fun part. All you do is you just take each of the sections of the bow like this, and you pull them apart like that. And then you take these, and you pull them apart like that. You take these, pull them apart. Oh, so satisfying. You take this, pull apart like this. And then, okay, so we have this side. Now, see how flat they all are? All you're going to do is take them and fluff them, which is easy because it's wired. So they have, the edges are going to be like this. You just pull them apart and fluff each of your sections like this. And then until you kind of, and you keep pulling them because you want them, you kind of want to make sure that they have enough. There we go. Okay, just like that. And you guys can see, and you can fluff the bow just like that on that side. And then you go to the other side and you repeat the exact same process like this. I sometimes even twist them to give them a little bit of, you're just trying to make sure it's fluffy on all sides. So you twist like that, pull them apart and twist, pull apart and twist, and pull apart and twist. And then you're going to fluff the edges like this and like this. Oh, y'all, I love making bows. This is so fun. Okay, then you go like this, and then fluff this side like this, and this side like this. And then when you're done, you come and you kind of make sure it's pulled up in the back. And then, like, I love the little tail sitting out like that. And kind of scrunch the, kind of maybe the smaller pieces in the front together like this. And then we are... There is our super cute bow. Is that not the cutest bow ever? Okay, now, I want to show you guys a few quick tips, like fun things that I'm doing with the bow. So I'm taking this bow, and then I got, while I was at Hobby Lobby, so I'm actually taking these bows, and I'm putting, will you grab me one of those stockings right there on the floor? I want to show them what it looks like. So these bows are actually going on my stockings. So here is a stocking, and I'm going to be hanging this up. I'll put a picture on here later of what it looks like. But then I'm just tying these bows to the top of the stocking like that. And then I found, like, I thought it'd be super cute too if you wanted to even add a little tag in here like this. Or I also have these really cute wooden tags that I thought would be cute hanging from the bottom of the stocking. So that's it. Isn't this the simplest bow on the planet? Now, does anybody have any questions about it? Anybody have any questions on how to make the bow? Because I just think this is such an easy, fun way, and you didn't need the florist wire. You didn't have to have fancy snippers. And the best part is you could just keep fluffing it until it's exactly the perfect bow that you want. And it looks like this. Fun. Does anybody have any questions?
Not yet, no.
Okay, awesome. All right, well, y'all, I want to show you also this, too. I don't know if anybody is still looking. Oh, I just love this bow. Okay, y'all, seriously, how long did that take me? Like 4 minutes to make? It's so, so simple and easy. And such a fun Christmas thing. And this ribbon, I mean, I can probably get out of this ribbon, I think probably 3 bows out of this ribbon. So you could make 3 bows for, you know, under $5 a piece. Also, too, I don't know if any of you guys are still interested, but we just finished these super fun trees right here I just finished in my Christmas craft class that I do every Saturday. It's not too late to join. We have all the sessions taped, but next week we're going to be making this amazing, beautiful Christmas art with a beautiful wreath and a bow and a fun piece of artwork. And then the week after that, we're going to make ornaments. So if you guys want to join, I can put the link here if you're interested in joining that. Every Saturday, I just sit here like this and just create together and make these incredible, fun crafts, just like these trees. We made these 3 trees this morning. All the supplies and everything you need are linked in the group, too. So I would love it if you would join me. And it's been so much fun hanging out with you guys today. I hope that, before we go, I just want to give you a little bit of encouragement. I know it's been kind of a challenging season, and there's a lot going on in our world right now, but I just want to encourage you and let you know how special you are and amazing you are. And I want to be one of the first people to wish you a very Merry Christmas. You got this, friend. You got this.